They've dominated Republican politics for more than a decade, but that may be coming to an end. There are some surprising new trends among evangelical Christians and religion in general that could impact potentially major in a major way on the presidential race and those to come. Let's go to Brian Todd. He's taking a much closer look at what we're seeing. What is going on, Brian?
Well, Wolf, a new survey shows Americans are moving around quite a lot in their religious affiliations, and that's presenting new political challenges for both parties. And the Republicans may not be able to look quite the same at their evangelical base again.
The power of the evangelical movement, a traditional staple of the Republican Party base. But that could be changing. A new survey by the Pew Forum on Religion and Public Life shows while the ranks of evangelicals are growing and remain strong, even outnumbering Catholics now, they may be splintering politically.
Evangelicals may not be as united politically as they were in the past because of all the new people that have been joining their churches that have different perspectives.
Jim Wallace, a left-leaning evangelical author, says the new ranks of evangelicals have broader political priorities.
Young evangelicals think that Jesus probably cares more about those 30,000 children who died today because of utterly preventable poverty and disease than he would about gay marriage amendments in Ohio. That's the change in the agenda.
Other observers believe the evangelical movement's anti-abortion, anti-gay marriage base is intact and still influential in the GOP, but is increasingly looking over its shoulder.
There is a concern, no doubt, within the old guard, so to speak, that some of these other issues are taking the place of some of these culture war attitudes.
Another striking part of the Pew survey, more than a quarter of American adults say they've left the faith of their childhood in favor of another sect or no religion at all. 16% say they're not affiliated with any faith, a larger percentage than at any time in recent memory. Analysts say that could also change America's political landscape.
In several election cycles now, we have seen that Democrats attract secular voters and non-affiliated voters. And if that percentage of the American population is increasing, one would expect that that would translate into a new core constituency of secular or non-affiliated, spiritual but not religious people for the Democrats.
But analysts say that, in fact, may present a challenge for the Democrats. At the same time, their natural constituency of secular voters is growing, they say. Democratic candidates have become more religious in their rhetoric, clearly trying to reach out to more traditional religious and, yes, evangelical voters. And now they have to balance all of it. Wolf?
Fascinating.